Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Catherine Clayton. A few crew members said goodbye. Preparations for a serious spacewalk and plenty of science make for another busy week on the International Space Station. Three station crew members closed the hatch on their Soyuz spacecraft, undocked from station, and made the trip back to Earth. NASA astronaut Nick Hague, Expedition 60 and Roscosmos cosmonaut Alexei Otikin, and United Arab Emirates astronaut Hazza Ali Al-Manzouri ended their time on station Thursday. Hague and Otikin completed a 203-day mission that spanned 3,248 orbits of Earth, or 80.8 million miles. This was Hague's second spaceflight and the third for Otikin. Al-Manzouri wrapped up an 8-day stay on the station. Their undocking marked the beginning of Expedition 61. European Space Agency astronaut Luca Parmitano will command the Expedition 61 crew, comprised of NASA astronauts Christina Cook, Jessica Meir, and Andrew Morgan, and Russian cosmonauts Alexander Skvortsov and Oleg Skripalka. And things kick into high gear for the crew this Sunday with the first of five complex spacewalks scheduled in October. The spacewalkers will continue the ongoing work to upgrade the large external batteries on the station, swapping older nickel-hydrogen batteries with new lithium-ion batteries recently delivered on the Japanese HTV-8. The upcoming battery swaps will be unique from previous spacewalks, which use extensive robotics to do the heavy lifting. The batteries set to be replaced starting on Sunday are located on the far end of the station's backbone, also called the truss, and are out of range for the Canada Arm 2. This means the astronauts will have to carry the 400-plus pound battery packs back and forth by hand. Sunday's spacewalk is expected to last over 6 hours, with coverage on NASA TV starting at 6:30 a.m. Eastern. Amidst the departures and the spacewalk preparations, astronaut Christina Cook still had time for science. She kept the biomolecule extraction and sequencing technology, or BEST investigation, on task with sample transfers and culture media exchanges. DNA sequencing allows researchers to explore the molecular world. The BEST investigation seeks to advance sequencing in space in three ways: identifying microbes that cannot be detected using traditional methods, assessing microbial mutations in the genome because of spaceflight, and performing direct RNA sequencing. Sequencing in space allows for real-time snapshot of gene expression, which will help protect humans during future space exploration missions and help monitor the presence of microbes in remote locations on Earth. Keep sending in your questions using the hashtag AskNASA, and we'll see you next week.
Subscribe for more space.